Morning, everyone. Welcome back to Twisted Shadow. Today we got the Sun God. It's all about authority. And there's two types of authority. There's more broad community world authority, and then there's personal authority. So I think the deeper questions that we should be asking today is what makes a person an authority to us? Is it something they have earned from us? Or is it something that other people tell us? You know, they say, oh, this person's an authority in this. Or, oh, this person wrote this book, so they're an authority in this. Or, oh, this person did this research and they're an authority in this. Is that authority that we're giving to other people something that is being earned personally, you know, by our perceptions and experience of them? Or is it something that we're just going along with and giving to somebody? These are pretty big distinctions. Too often we're, you know, told that, you know, somebody's an authority because they, you know, either published a book or wrote a paper or got a degree or got a certificate or something of that realm. They have done some type of accomplishment in this area and have received some type of outward certificate or physical thing, like a book or whatever. And in our collective, we say that that makes them an authority. But I don't think it should. I think we should be determining based on, you know, the actual information or their actual presentation and what they are actually doing, not just a book or a paper or a certificate. I love to use this phrase that the last, you know, the lowest grade person that goes through medical school and graduates is still called doctor. We use that all the time in the hospital and said it to each other. So just because they hold a title does not make them an authority on something. Just because they wrote a book, just because they have a huge following, doesn't mean that they are an authority on something. They put their knowledge out there. They put their experience out there. That's wonderful. But we need to be choosing for ourselves who we consider an authority is. I mean, think about history. We have tons of artists, composers, scientists that during their living life generally were not, you know, revered. They weren't considered these authority figures in these areas. It wasn't until after they died that they got that status. And we need to think about that. You know, why? Why did that happen? Why was it after their death? And then we need to be thinking, why do we see them as an authority? Is it because that's what history is telling us? Is that what other people are telling us? Or do we see things in there that, you know, show that they are that, you know, knowledgeable authority type person, somebody that can be trusted to be listened to? And when we talk about authority, it's really trust. Trust and honesty, in my opinion. that's not how we define authority. You know, it's about the knowledge, the abilities, the experience, what they're putting out. But we need to be able to trust that they are being honest. Which brings me to the deeper authority, and that's authority of self. We need to be the authorities of ourselves. We need to be a leader for ourselves. No one knows us better than us. No one knows our experience better than us. No one knows what we're learning better than us as far as how we're incorporating or using it, not the actual information that we're learning. But when it comes to us, we should always be our biggest authority, our biggest defender, our you know, it's yourself. It is your sacred self. And so that trust and honesty is embedded in this. How can we be an authority of ourselves if we're not being honest with ourselves? And you think that would be a simple concept. You would think that people just do that. I mean, I don't understand how people can lie to themselves. I haven't figured that one out yet. Everybody keeps telling me it's possible, and I just don't see it. And so, but we can't do that. We can't lie to ourselves. We know the truth. We know what our experience is. We know what we've learned. We know the knowledge and the wisdom we have gained, especially as we get older and have more hindsight and gain more wisdom. And so as we go through that growing process, as we go through those transformations, we should be looking at ourselves as an authority on us, not letting other people dictate to you, you know, that you're right or you're wrong about your own personal experience. And it's your experience, it's not theirs. And even though we may have similar experiences or be working with same deity or be working on same spell, our individual experience is going to be different. It's going to be unique because it's tailored to us. And that's something that I think a lot of people tend to forget. We get caught up in the, okay, this is what they're saying, and so this is what this should look like, and this is what I should be experiencing. And then when they don't, they start falling down the pit of the imposter syndrome, thinking, oh, well, I must not, you know, be good enough, or I must not have that ability, or I must, you know, be an outsider, or I failed at it, or whatever the thing. It's a vicious, nasty cycle that doesn't need to happen. But we do need to be honest. We need to be honest when we're talking about our experiences. We need to be honest and not embellishing them to make us seem bigger, or make us seem more, you know, magical or ethereal or however you want to put it. I mean, talk in regular language. You don't need to have all this flairy language in order to get your message across or to, you know, explain an experience to someone. Because all we do when we embellish is we kind of go against that authority. You know, we're not being honest, and we're doing it from a place of arrogance and trying to make people see us in a different light. I don't know. It's hard because people embellish for all kinds of reasons. But if you're talking about like an experience that you're trying to share, and you're trying to share it in a way of facts, and this is just honest what happened, yet you embellish to make it sound better, use bigger words to make it sound better and make people think that you're bigger than you are, you take away from that experience. You're distorting it in a way that is taking away the authority of it and the authority of yourself. Of course, these are all my opinions on this. For me, today, on authority. Still working on my bridge spell. So this is really tying into that, because there's some things that have come up with my bridge spell that that bring up some slight fears, and these are things that I know aren't reality. Yet, you know, all these things that I've seen in my life, and you know, all the fiction that's out there, you know, brings in these awkward little fears. And so I need to be an authority of self. And it's not that I'm not going to stop fearing, because I don't think I'm going to get rid of it that easy. And I think it's going to be through experience is how I lose fear. But I'm going to use courage, which means I'm going to do it anyway and go forward, fear or not. But I'm also going to stay clear in my boundaries. I am going to set other boundaries for this and be very clear in them and become an authority in this. Not for the world, for myself, for what I'm starting to work with these particular, this particular door, we'll put it that way. So I'm not ready yet to tell you about it. I'm still in the middle. But it's going to require me to create some different structures and to have confidence in the fact that I'm in control. Not of everything, but I'm in control of myself, and I'm in control of what comes in and what can go out. And these are important for what I'm doing. So my thing is what is your things on authority right now? How do you see authority? How do you determine who's an authority for you? What is the criteria there for you? And then on authority of self, are we really the ones controlling ourselves, or are we allowing other things and other people to dictate that to us? Are we allowing our fears to control versus us controlling and being in authority in that position? Things to think about and some new perspectives to think about. All right, so this has gone on long enough. I've done a lot of rambling. This has been a hard one. It's been a hard one to put into words, because authority means so many different things to so many different people. And you wouldn't think that it does, but it does. And how we do criteria for that, what makes somebody an authority, it's shifting and it's changing. But it should always be personal, not somebody telling us that this person's an authority and then just believing it and going along with it. So yeah, okay, I'm going to leave this here. You all can think about it and, you know, make some decisions. Rethink some of the people that you think are authorities. What makes them that way? Why do you believe they're an authority now? And then personal authority. How do you become that for yourself? Have a good day.